Arr, where be that treasure? I feel like me been walking for hours. I think I'll be taking a break right here. Yes, this be a nice spot.
Pirate Phil?
It is you!
Ah, Ned! Isn't it in my favorite landlubber?
I'm so tired. We've been walking for hours and we've finished all our snacks and water.
Ah, well, I be just about to have some of my snacks and water, so why don't ye have some?
Cool, thanks.
Ah, ye said we. Who be with you, lad? And why you be here?
Ned, there you are. Hey there, Pirate Phil.
Ah, I see you been with Lucy. Well, Lucy, you thirsty? Have some of me water. Ha ha ha, some food here.
Pirate Phil said he'll share with us.
I guess Ned didn't tell you how many we are, huh?
How many we are? Blimey! What be all of ye doing here? Me food and me water not be enough to feed this whole lot of you. This be funny though. Cause it be reminding me of this story in the Bible where thar be many mouths to feed and not much food to feed with. If I recall, the story be going a little something like this.
This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He did many miracles and healed people of their sickness.
Oh, hey everyone!
A huge crowd kept following him wherever he went because they saw his miraculous signs as he healed the sick. Crowds started to gather around Jesus. There were 5,000 men and many more women and children. Turning to Philip, he asked,
Hey, Philip!
Where can we buy bread to feed all these people? You see, Jesus was testing Philip, for he already knew what he was going to do. Philip replied, Even if we worked for months, we wouldn't have enough money to feed them.
Hey, I got an idea.
Then Andrew spoke up. There's a young boy here with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good is that with this huge crowd? Jesus said, Tell everyone to sit down.
Right, everyone, sit down.
Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks to God, and gave them to the people.
Here you go.
Afterward, he did the same with the fish, and they all ate as much as they wanted.
Want some more?
I'm all good, thanks.
After everyone was full, Jesus told his disciples, Now gather the leftovers so that nothing is wasted.
You got it.
So they picked up the pieces and filled 12 baskets with scraps, left by the people who had eaten from the 5 barley loaves and 2 fish.
Is it that Jesus took a little bit of food and fed an entire crowd? What's more mind-blowing is, there were still leftovers. After feeding 5,000 men from only 5 loaves and 2 fishes, there were still 12 baskets to fill. 12! I wonder what happened to Pirate Phil, Ned, Lucy, and our friends.
I be loving that story every time me hear it. It reminds me always to trust in God and see how He be working in all situations, like...
Wow, hey, what's that?
Coconuts, we won't be hungry anymore.
Thank you, Lord!
Blimey! There be more than enough coconuts here for all of us!
It's time for a memory verse today. Because of what happened earlier in our story for today, I want to share with you Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. Read it with me. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. My God will use His wonderful riches in Christ Jesus to give you everything you need.
Ahoy there, Ned, me matey! I could not help myself, but overhear what me friend be sharing. I be wanting to add something too. God be a powerful God, and we should not be doubting what He can do. He be always giving us what we be needing at the right moment. He may not give us what we be wanting, but surely He always be giving us what we be needing. Sometimes, even more.
Yep, I still have the coconuts to bring home to my parents and other friends.
Ye be having coconuts growing out of your ears in no time, me laddie. That's how much He be providing for us.
Hello, welcome to my show, Get Crafty with Lucy. Teacher Amy is here to help us with our craft today.
Hi kids. Hey Lucy. What are we going to make today? I'm excited.
A basket, so that I will always remember what happened to us earlier.
Care to share what happened earlier?
Ned and our friends went trekking and we finished all our food and water. Then we saw Pirate Phil and he offered us his food. We thought his food would not be able to feed all of us, but then something amazing happened. We realized we were standing under coconut trees. We didn't have to worry about our food and being hungry.
Wow! It's amazing to see how God works in order to provide for our needs. So why a basket?
Even though it seems empty, just like the 12 baskets that were filled with leftovers from today's story, God will fill it up with what I need or even more in His perfect time.
Aww, that's a nice reminder, Lucy. I'm ready, and what do I need to do?
First, we need 2 paper plates, scissors, paint, and markers, and anything that you want to decorate your basket with. We will draw this pattern to both paper plates, and then we will cut along these lines that we made. After that, we will decorate the paper plates to make it look like a basket. And then staple them together. And we're done! Now we have a basket!
That was easy and fun!
I'm glad you enjoyed, Teacher Amy. I hope you like our craft today, kids. See you again next time on Get Crafty with Lucy! Bye!
Hello again! I hope you enjoyed our episode for today. Remember that God loves us so much and He cares for us and He knows us well. There are times when we don't even know what we need, but no doubt, He knows it and He will meet our needs in His perfect time. Sometimes, He will give us even more than we need in ways we won't expect. Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for loving us. You know everything that is happening in our lives, and we thank you because you promised to give us what we need. We pray that our hearts will continue to trust in you and have faith and not worry. Amen. Thank you for joining us. See you again next time. Bye!